Scene change, new chapters. My jersey's in the rafters. How I would have done it over, harder, better, faster. If I'm ghost, then I'm Casper. That's why I call you boo. This ain't normally some type of shit I do. I've been caught up in this moment. Wonder if you notice. Now when I'm around you, I can't even focus. When you're not around, I feel down in my lowest. Will you catch me now, or are you just as hopeless? Oh no. Is it gravity, or are we falling in love? Is it gravity, or are we falling in love? Is it gravity, or are we falling in love? We fall, I guess we're falling in love. Is it gravity?
Good morning. Okay, it's like 1 p.m., so I apologize for that, but I wanted to just give an intro to this before I work out, because I never actually do that, and I think it's an entertaining way to watch a video. Yeah, so I'm going to be filming a variety of upper body exercises that are like very basic but important for everyone to do. This is more for like beginners, so if you're not a beginner, then you can still watch and maybe you'll learn something. But these are primarily exercises that I would teach someone if they were a beginner to the gym who wanted to learn how to work out. And I'm not like the strongest person ever, but like I will do my best to instruct as effectively as I possibly can. So I'll film it and do a voiceover, all that fun stuff. Hopefully I'll look like more put together during the voiceover. And this is my life now. So all of my books, they were on my bed before, so I feel like I have made progress. I can't hold this camera. Okay, that wasn't how I was supposed to start that. But, hello, I had this elaborate plan of wearing eyeliner and like getting dressed properly and then recording this video before bed. And it didn't happen, so now, instead, I am going to do my voiceover like this. I found lipstick in my backpack and put it on, and hopefully that kind of helps make this look a little bit more bearable, you know? So, today in the gym, I couldn't figure out what the best thing to film was. So what I decided to do was make it a very beginner-focused like filming session. So I recorded two separate groups of exercises. So I'm gonna walk you through everything that I did, and then we're gonna go from there. So the first thing I did was record exercises, at least one per muscle group in your upper body. So I'm going to go through those right now. And the first exercise that I wanted to show you was a lateral raise, or in some people prefer to call it a side raise. Essentially, you are working the side of your shoulder by doing that. And what that does is it creates some definition around your upper arm so that the muscles look a little bit more separate, so you have a more like toned, put together look, I think. This is all, by the way, my personal opinion on like how, like what muscles like should stand out. Like, you do you in terms of what aesthetic you want to go for. I like the idea of having defined muscles in my upper body because it just makes me look leaner. So that was the first exercise I did. I'm using a very light weight for demonstrative purposes, but don't go too heavy on these. It's completely not necessary to get the effect that you need. And what I do is I go up until shoulder level and then I come down, but I do it everything as slowly as I can because that's how you stretch the muscle more, put more tension on it, and then that's what motivates your muscle to grow, essentially. And I like side raises as well because I often feel that we're always obsessed with going up when it comes to working shoulders, that it's important to remember that you can also go, you know, to the side. There are also like a bunch of other reasons, but I think it's also really fun, so I'm biased. The second exercise that I want to show you is a standard bicep curl, but with like a little bit of a twist. So instead of only curling in front of your body, which is a very common exercise that I think is great, I'm showing you a version where you curl up in front of your body, turn your arms out, and then curl outwards, and then you alternate. And what that does is it puts stresses on different parts of your biceps so that you're basically getting more bang for your buck, and your muscles will fatigue a little faster, and it just, I feel like it just makes you look cooler. So that's a big motivating factor for most of the exercises I do. How can I look the most cool in the gym? But regardless, your bicep is made up of multiple muscles. And by repositioning where the dumbbell is, you basically put tension on more of the muscles. And I think that for time's sake, you should just get as much as you can done in like one set as possible. So that's another thing I recommend. The bicep, if anyone's confused, like if this is my arm, the bicep is like the top muscle here. And if that looks more defined, your arm just looks tighter. The next exercise that I wanted to show you was a dumbbell row. And this is a standing row. And you can do one arm at a time if you prefer. I'm showing you with both arms at a time. You have to keep your core really, 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 really tight. And then you pull the weight towards you, pause, hold it for a second, and then slowly go back and repeat. This is really like wonderful for like your mid back and for just like drawing in the muscles in the back so that some people hold more fat in their back. What that'll do is by building some muscle there, you'll add some shape so that you can just get really, really nice looking muscles. I couldn't think of anything coherent to say. Regardless, by doing this, you will also work on your posture a lot. And if you squeeze your shoulders back, don't round your shoulders, squeeze your shoulders back. You'll also just help maintain good core strength as well so that, you know, day-to-day activities, you're like more efficient and like productive and you don't complain of back pain when you carry groceries. That's happened to me before, so just trying to help out. The next exercise that I want to show you is a tricep extension. An overhead tricep extension because you're doing it over your head, like logically. The tricep is like the other side of your arm, so this is the bicep. The tricep is going to be underneath. Many women will like show me their arm like this and say, how do I tackle the bottom of my arm? So here's what this will do. And what you need to focus on is first keep your core really tight because you have to stand up straight for this to be, you know, good for you. And extend the weight all the way down and then come all the way up, only using the back of your arm. Don't jump, don't like fling your arm forward because then you're not really working the muscle that you're trying to work. Lower the weight, but like don't compromise in the form for it. Again, go slowly, go controlled. You can do one arm at a time, you can use only one dumbbell at a time and like hold it between your hands, whatever is easiest for you. And focus on just making sure you're stretching the muscle as much as you possibly can, because when the muscle is in tension is when the muscle fibers will rip, and then that's when the new muscle will grow, and then that's how you become stronger and all of that fun stuff that I think you're here for, or you're here for, I don't know why else you'd be here. But another exercise that I wanted to show you is actually for the back of your shoulders. We're really, really bad as like a society at focusing on muscles you can't see. And often because we're wearing shirts and because we're looking forward, we forget that there's a muscle on the back of your shoulder. And that muscle is very important, the rear delt, simply because it helps you stand up straight. And in a society where we're all, like often, I myself included, rounding our shoulders forward in order to type while we're watching TV, they basically weaken, they become smaller, they serve no purpose. So by doing exercises that target those, like what I'm showing you here, a rear delt fly, you're making sure that you're giving that muscle attention. Your shoulders, the front of your shoulders, won't become too dominant or too strong in comparison. And you know, you'll like probably grow an inch because you'll be able to stand up straight. And as someone who's not like genetically like gifted in the height department, I think that's important. So and the last exercise that I want to show you for this, you know, group of exercises is a floor chest press. I want to make sure I showed you exercises that didn't require a bench, just in case you don't have access to one and you literally only have dumbbells with you. So by lying on the floor and keeping your hands out wide, you will do a wide chest press. It basically hits like the major pectoral muscles like here, and you feel buff, you feel strong. I think it's fun to do it from the floor. The only thing that the floor doesn't allow you to do is like overstretch the muscle, which is fine because, you know, it's a different challenge coming off the ground and having to propel the weight forward. Be careful with it. If you feel like the weight is too heavy, please drop to a lower weight. And if while you're doing the exercise you feel like it's unsafe, just please like don't let the weight drop on your face. That's like, if I could give one tip, that would be probably like the best tip. I can't speak English today, I'm really sorry. The next thing that I wanted to show all of you was a push-up type of sequence. And what this means is a standard push-up, like on your toes, on your hands, is very difficult, especially if you're new to the gym, new to working out. And I wanted to show some progressions that get you to a full push-up if you've never done one before or if you're having some trouble. I think the biggest mistake people do is they try and just do the end, like most challenging type of push-up, or like the standard one, without prepping themselves, and then like they become discouraged, they can barely do one, and that's like, it's unproductive. So instead, I want to show you first some bench versions, and the first one I'm doing is a wide grip, and I'm on my knees. It's the easiest version that I'm going to be showing you, and I'm performing it with my core really tight. I'm locking back my shoulders and just focusing on using the muscles here. You can't really see them, but using the muscles here to push myself up, and that basically, you know, helps strengthen any muscle that you need to. Push-ups are also, just in case you are wondering, are wonderful and brilliant for building core strength. So keep your core really tight, your abs really tight. They're really good for chest and for your triceps, so like the bottom of the arm again. The next thing I'm going to show you is a close grip bench push-up. This is more challenging because you have to use your arm muscles a little more. So you can see I'm struggling with this a little bit. And just, again, focus on keeping your head straight in line with your back and keeping your elbows tight so that you're working on your tricep. The next variation is off of a bench, but instead of kneeling, I'm keeping my legs straight and I'm on my toes. So this would be like the next step in like getting towards like the full push-up. Again, I'm doing a wide grip one first and then a narrow grip one right after. And this basically teaches you how to feel the different muscles that you're working. So how to feel like if you're primarily focused on your chest, if you're primarily focused on your arms, if you want to go back and forth. I wanted to give you those options. I find the tricep focus one, so when your hands are really close together, your elbows are against your side, very difficult because my triceps are weaker. And I should probably do something about that. So this was also really informative for me. And the next progression is on the floor. So without the bench, but you're on your knees, which is still like decreasing the load on your arms and your upper body. So it's still like more manageable. And I'm talking really fast. I'm like out of breath right now. Oh God. So on your knees, first the wide grip one and then the narrow one. These narrow ones are actually pretty difficult. I didn't realize that. I thought this would be simple, but it was not. For the wide grip ones and for the narrow ones, focus on going down as low as you can and then pushing up. If your wrists start to hurt, I didn't show this in the video, but I've encountered some people who have this issue. It could mean like you have weaker forearms, so like this part of your arm, like mine, is very like skinny in comparison to the rest of my body, so it's not very strong. If it hurts, I would suggest using a fist and pushing off from a fist. It protects your wrists a little bit more. And the final variation is obviously like the full one. I do I'm only showing you 10 of the wide grip ones. Fun fact, I can do like, I think only 27, so I should like work on that. And then I fail when I try and do the tricep one because I haven't done those in like, I think a year, so I'm sorry about that. But in case you're a Jedi and you can do that, then please go for it. Until then, I'll like work on it, but yeah. Also, another exciting thing. I did this workout like the same day that I'm filming this, so I'm really excited about this. Before my workout, I decided to try pull-ups and see like just how many I could do, because the last time I did unassisted, so like just me and a bar holding on for dear life, I was able to do three full ones. And I was pumped about that because I'd never been able to do that before, so I thought I'd like give it a try. And I was able to do like six. And I have footage of it, so I know it happened, and I am so excited. So like little things like that make me really happy amidst like law school and reading and homework. Yeah, that's really like the happy advice that I had for you. But I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it was helpful. I am sorry for not wearing a proper shirt. I probably should have done that, but I am repping my school, like my old school, so New York University. I think that's it. Oh, I think I also have a random clip of me doing push-ups just because I wanted to prove that I could do them, but like by the end of the video when I was filming it, I was exhausted. So yeah, that's about it. I hope you had fun, and I will see you guys next time. Try these exercises and let me know how they go. Also, I say that a lot, but I forgot to tell all of you that I do in fact offer online personal training. What that basically means is I write you a program for 12 weeks and we have check-ins, and there's a lot of other stuff included that I'm not going to bore you with right now. But if you're interested and you want to just talk about it, find out some more information, then please email me at fitness360withalina@gmail.com. The email's in the description. I'll try putting it somewhere like in the screen right now. And I would love to work with anyone who wants to learn how to use strength training and building muscle so you can like lose fat and like all of that really fun stuff. There's also nutrition included. That's a question I get asked a lot. So if you're interested, let me know. But until next time.